If you're in a survival situation and it's windy outside, matches can be extremely unreliable, and they certainly won't light a fire when they're wet. So in this project, let's try using a bit of backyard science to take the trouble out of lighting your tinder, because with this special mix, the tinder lights itself. Let's begin this project with the soda cap container we made in a previous project. They're lightweight, cheap to make, and amazingly useful, so look for how to build them in another video. Now our matchless fire starter is about as simple as mixing two chemicals together, potassium permanganate and a bit of glycerin. These items are sometimes found in survival kits already because of their healing properties and water treatment abilities, but mix them together and it opens up a whole new world of possibilities. This purple product is sold commercially as a rejuvenator for certain types of water filters, and I found mine in the water treatment section of a pool supply store. Now it might look like a harmless black sand, but it's actually a powerful oxidizer. This stuff can be poisonous and burn your skin, so just make sure you're well aware of the risks before you try handling it. Some people have used it for disinfecting water, making antiseptic solutions, providing antifungal treatment for hands and feet, and making emergency signals on snow. Now I loaded up one half of my container using a spoon and a funnel, and that seemed to work pretty well to prevent spills. Now let's screw the cap back on nice and tight so the powder is locked in securely where it should be kept safe and dry. Alright, now we can add the glycerin to the other side. I found this bottle at a local super center, but they can be found just as easily at drug, craft, and baking stores as well. Glycerin is typically used as a moisturizer in creams and lotions, but it has some really cool uses for first aid and survival situations as well. Some people have used it to relieve insect bites, sunburns, chemical burns, and some even say it works as a mild mosquito and ant repellent. You may have noticed I color-coded the ends of my container with different caps, and that's to help identify which chemicals are in which end. Since the container is made out of bottle caps, it's completely water-resistant, so everything stays dry even if the container gets completely submerged in water. Not only is it waterproof and incredibly small, but even when it's fully loaded, the whole thing weighs a mere 1 ounce, or about 29 grams. Chances are that's small and light enough to be added to any type of day pack without making any noticeable difference. Now let's go on a little trip to the mountains to see how this reacts when we mix the two chemicals together. First we'll need to open the black side, because that's the end with the potassium permanganate. Now since I was down by the river anyway, I thought this might be a good time to experiment with disinfecting water. All it takes is a very small pinch of potassium permanganate crystals in a liter of water to begin the disinfecting process. You can see when the crystals hit the water, they turn a deep purple, but if we put the lid on and mix it all around, the water should turn to a nice light pink. The saying is, as long as it's pink, it's probably okay to drink. Just make sure it's not purple and you should be alright. Okay, let's carefully pour the grains on a flat surface like a rock or a piece of wood, and I'm using about half the container for this demonstration. Now it's a good idea to push a little indentation into the center of the pile, so when we pour the glycerin on top, it'll be held neatly in place right in the center. These next few seconds feel like nothing is happening, but make sure you've got some dry leaves, twigs, and other lightweight kindling gathered up, because when this reaction happens, it's gonna happen fast. It can take anywhere up to a minute to notice anything changing, but if you look closely now, you should start to see the glycerin soaking down into the powder and starting to smoke. Make sure you've got your dry leaves ready, because the heat and smoke will continue to build rapidly until the pile spontaneously bursts into flames. Let's go ahead and gently set our leaves and sticks over top, and you should be able to see how quickly the flames begin to build. Now if you've left a little gap at the bottom for air to get in, your matchless survival fire should continue to build quickly on its own, without having to put in any extra effort. Congratulations, you've just started a fire without matches. And now that you've got a healthy flame, why don't you try making yourself a batch of char cloth? This stuff is another must-have for emergency fire starting, and is so sensitive to heat, you can easily start future fires with your water bottle, so look for the video on how to make char cloth as well. Now whatever you do, don't ever mix glycerin directly into the same compartment as the potassium permanganate. I tried screwing the lid back on to seal out any oxygen, but the potassium permanganate is still a strong enough oxidizer to start the reaction. And like any airtight container holding a rapidly expanding gas, it's eventually gonna blow. So if you want to err on the side of caution and avoid any unnecessary messes, feel free to store your ingredients in completely separate containers. Well, now you know how to take two very different but very useful emergency kit items and mix them together to get an awesome synergistic benefit, the Matchless Survival Fire. If you like this project, perhaps you like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com. Hello, random citizen, and thanks again for watching another one of my videos all the way to the end. This one was actually a collaboration with another YouTube channel based out of Canada called Cottage Life. It's two brothers that have made a commitment to do an outdoor project every month. And if you like my projects, I really think you're gonna like theirs as well. They're just learning as they go, but the episodes are really well produced, and they've already made a few videos like how to make beer bottle glasses and a floating dock. That's actually really cool. So go check out some of their projects and let them know that Grant Thompson sent you. You might want to think about subscribing to keep up with some of their future episodes as well. Thanks for supporting my videos, and I'll see you in the next one with some more random hacks of science. In the meantime, I'll be looking for you down in the comments. We'll see you there.